Hey, g'day guys, how you going? Welcome back to another video. I've come out today to one of my main blocks that I hunt, and we've been looking, scouting for the rut, looking what bucks are about, and I was here the other night, about 7 o'clock or so, and close to last light. And down over there, there's the biggest fella buck I've ever seen. And yeah, he's an absolute screamer. So anyway, I've come down, I've got one camera with me. I'm gonna put a camera down where I saw him. And yeah, we've got a few goats around. There's actually some handy billies straight down here, I'll show you. There's a few handy ones in that mob. Wind's blowing over me, but we might sneak down and have a look and get a close look on those fellas, see if there's anything, you know, that might be worth taking. Yeah, main job, get this camera out. And, mate, if we run into him, I will have a crack at him. I'm stocked up with methylated spirits at home just in case, so preserved velvet and a bit of Velvalock. So, and this time of year is the best time to kill them to eat them, so I'll be stoked to get one to eat, because the amount of fat they'd have on them from all this summer feed. Anyway, kick back, and we'll get cracking along and see what we can find though. We're on an open hillside where those big billies are. The best things about these SPIKA zone pans is how smooth they are. I'll put the camera up on my legs here and just, how's that? And I can just slide down this open hill. It's relatively easy. I'm not really pushing hard. Just want to make sure you cross your legs, so I don't have my gaiters on. If you cross your legs like that, you'll hold your pants from riding up. So yeah, I'm going to go head down to those trees, follow that wash down the bottom to these billies. Yeah, just keep sliding like this. I'm just pushing with one arm. Got my bar on my shoulders, camera in my lap. Yeah, when I slide down to the bottom, I'll probably get some good close-up footage of these fellas. Alright, I made it down the bottom. The big white billy caught a bit of my movement. I had to quickly stand up and readjust. He's sort of still looking up here, he's not 100%. Because I froze him and dropped down really low. This grass, so he's looking, but he doesn't know what he's looking at. All the other goats have no idea I'm here. I'd say if I just sit here for a bit, he'll get over it and go back to feeding, because all the others are relaxed. What I probably should do, just because of the time I'm on, I should just blow them out, because they would just go straight up to that scrub there. And yeah, then they're out of my way, and I could keep pursuing that fellow buck or do the job that I came to do and get that camera up. Let's give you a quick glimpse. Anyway, there's a few other goats. Some are pretty close. I might just sit here for a bit and just see what happens. Slide way up there. All right, that big goat, he's gone back, he's relaxed again. I might sneak in a bit closer and see how we go. There's just so many eyes here. I think I might just go blow them out. Like, there's nothing really of interest to take there, so I've got to keep on this clock. Anyway, I'm just going to blow them out. They can run off, happy days. Don't matter, we'll go do what we got to do. Alright, we just smashed it up to the top of this hill. You can see we're pretty on top of the world here. I know I say that a lot, but they really are. Beautiful view out there. So we came over that ridge, that last one, big spider on my lens. the deer, I saw the other day, is down in there. Way down that scrub. Down in there. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna follow this ridge, keeping our sight down the bottom. We're gonna go across and cut through all that timber. In case he's down there, or there are some deer there. So if we don't spook anything again, we'll go get this camera hung, and then we'll focus on a bit of hunting. But anyway, yeah, we slogged it over here pretty quick. I'm actually half impressed I did that. But anyway, we'll just keep walking, because yeah, we've got another big hill to climb up on the way back to deer for this hunt. Anyway, let's get down. There's a heap of goats just showed up down there. Hopefully they're relaxed, because I'll have to if they're not, if there's anything down there, they'll blow them out, but at least we'll get the camera hung, I guess. Anyway, we'll go down and get it done. Alright, I've gotten distracted again. Just belting down here, I'm almost down where I want to be. Just down back here, been bumping into mobs of goats and that. And now, I got some piggies. I have no idea the balls of sows. But I've not seen pigs for a while now. It's all open country and I'm going to go have a crack. As long as I just keep to the shadow, get out of this cornflake stuff. And then there was goats there, but they ran past them. So the pigs didn't notice the goats. They're feeding pretty hard, so they got their heads down. I'll get into this scrub. Oh shit, that wasn't good. In there. And the wind might be okay. If not, oh well. They seem to be moving a bit. So while the heads are down, I'm moving. Because this whole place is pretty much bloody open, so it makes it very hard stalking. Anyway, as soon as we get in here, I'll be able to hide from the other side of the hill there on and come up on top of them. Hopefully with an arrow knocked in a good range and let one fly and get it all on the GoPro. Anyway, see what happens. I left all the babies here. There they smelt me. There's some goats here, bud. Maybe they've been good here. And pigs went. Oh well, the goats didn't smell me, but the pigs did. I was all a bit rushed, I will admit. Goats haven't smelt me, they're just there. And the pigs went that way. Or the piglets just did, two sows obviously. Or maybe boring a sow, who knows. The piglets just pissed off that way, but yeah, they must have smelt me. I tested the wind. I was blowing away from them, but there might have been a swirl there somewhere. Anyway, you can't win them all. But you can see where they are, you can see the grass moving. Anyway, I'll let them be. There's more goats up this gully. I've got a walker. And, yeah, hopefully we bloody run into a deer or something, but it's not looking too good. But anyway, as long as we get this camera hung, I'll be happy. There's a billy goat there. We'll see what's up here.
There we go, it's over. That's all she wrote. There he goes. Down. I just saw it took out a billy. He has very, his horns would look like grain into his face almost. So I decided to take the shot and take him out of a mob, the poor bugger. Like, literally horns are hooked back into his face by the look of it. But anyway, we'll go have a look for the arrow. It should be just there. And we'll go have a look at him, eh? Oh, we've got the arrow. He's right here. There, you got good blood on him. And so arrow's here, the billy was standing right here. And there is just there. I'll pace it out. 1, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 paces. Anyway, I'll leave him. I'll go get the gear and we'll come check him out, eh? Alright, here at the poor bugger. And you see the shot there. It's a perfect shot. You can see he only went 10 metres. That went straight for everything. It actually broke his leg. On the other side, just keep him stay there. Yeah, it's actually broke his shoulder. Yeah, completely on the exit. So it had a KUG 150 grain with that nap time shaft behind it. Absolutely pummeled him. Anyway, I'll show you what I was talking about with his from the arrow over there. What I was talking about with his horns. Look at this. Never seen one like this before. Grain into his head, so a bit maggoty, getting fly blown, eyes got a pus coming out of it, and it's actually indented into his skull. And now here, so it's been snapping here from the pressure, I think, of it going into his actual skull. So yeah, that's the reason I decided to take this poor bugger out, because yeah, that must be very bloody painful. It's getting a bit of shade, it's getting a bit warm in here still. So anyway, I'm gonna leave him be. I can get the ute down here. There's a track just there. I can bring it down in this flat and drive up to him and grab him, take him home for dogs. Anyway, we won't get bogged now. It's been that dry for a while, which is good. Anyway, good take one now. Let's get a few pics of him. And then we'll finally go and get his bloody camera set, eh? Focus on this bloody camera, eh? We'll get that hung up, anyway, we'll keep on moving. All right, this is where I saw that big buck. He came cruising up in this corner, and he tried to get under the fence here for some reason. I don't know why, those antlers on him, but he stood here today for a bit, and they made their way up the fence. So I'm thinking I'll put the camera up in these trees somewhere. I was thinking about putting it on this tree, and it will catch everything coming and going, but it's going to catch 50,000 kangaroos. There goes a deer right now. There it is. Meow. Yep, it's a young yearling. Well, we'll leave that. Yeah, that has a nice yearling just running up through there. Managed to pull her up with that little doe call to get a look at her for the binos.
Hey, I'm gonna bloody, I'll put the camera up here in this scrub, pointing back at sort of a trail, pacing up this fence, and I noticed a spot up there where he jumped, as I was on top of this hill. I was in the ute up there, and I'm glassing when I spotted him, so, I've seen a deer now, I've seen two deer, saw a deer back there too, so we're in a pretty good spot for it. We've been bloody pacing it. I'm getting a bit excited since I've been here. Oh, message from Hainsey saying, how you going, mate? I'm going to get service, I'll go check that out, give him a call, see what's happening. I'm not looking for help. Done 8.3Ks to hang a freaking camera. I've shot a goat that needed killing because poor bugger had horn grown into his friggin' eye socket and into his skull pretty much. And there's a bit of sign here actually. Let's see, this is a GoPro. A bit of rubbing. That could very well be pigs. I think in this tree, fairly worn in pad, we'll run a camera facing that way. And then we'll just see what we get, eh? Then we'll power out of here. Yeah, we'll see what's on top of there. We might run into something else before we get to the edge. Turn him on. Hope it bloody works. There we go, rating card. That's a bloody good sign. It's good when you see that. 6:49 the camera says, it's 7:47, so it's an hour behind, roughly an hour, hour and 10 or 50 minutes, whatever it is. Camera. Alright, I'll come back in a few days and we'll check him, have a drink. I'm friggin' dying. That's better. Grab his gear together and back on. Yeah, he's still got sun on the tops of the hills. It's not down here, but we are. Anyway, we come what we set out to do. We come and did what we set out to do. With a fair few distractions, but you get that on the big jobs. Anyway, I'm gonna load up the rest of my kit and start heading up the top of this bastard and see what's up there. We might come in something else yet. Anyway, see what we can do. Oh god. I've just smashed it from all the way. Way down there. And majority of the time I get on top of this ridge and Dreaser. There's normally deer, this time we're not grazing. Just on the other side. So I'm gonna get my breath. I'm gonna leave this camera just sitting here. I'll knock an arrow, put the GoPro in my head. And yeah, you never know what's gonna be on the other side. So yeah, we'll get prepared. And hopefully they're there. We can get some meat on the ground. So that'd be bloody awesome. Anyway, see what happens. I had a feeling I'd bust something in here. Every bloody time. Every time, that was a big buck. Saw the pig first, and then I saw the buck. Like you can hear, I'm walking, bloody hell. I've got freaking cornflakes, made some rain. Likes looking in this stuff. Hard to see, but hey, as I said, you know, every time you peek over this friggin' ridge, you'll see something, like a deer. Oh, he's a good buck. And another pig. Never seen so many pigs here. Anyway, we'll leave that buck alone. He didn't smell me, just heard something. And the way he was just prancing, and he wasn't bloody worried about anything. Anyway, we're gonna get the bloody camera. Oh, don't you just wish you'd spot them before they spot you sometimes? But then it'd just be too bloody easy. Anyway, it's been an absolutely epic bloody afternoon. Oh yeah, I've seen pigs, heap of goats, a massive buck. Got my camera set. Beautiful sunset. Now that we're up high. Looks a lot brighter on the GoPro, but setting out there. And yeah, not a bad way to close out a day. Absolutely beautiful country out here, mate. Alright guys, that's it for today's episode. Buddy, oh, great afternoon, massive walk just to put out one bloody camera. What'd we do? 9.5 kilometres we did this afternoon, tonight. So you know, we definitely made it worthwhile of a hunt. We knocked over that nice billy goat that, yeah, poor bugger, had his horn grown into his skull and that, and it was starting to get a bit maggoty. So it was fly blown, and yeah, his eye was all buggered and all shit coming out of it, so that wasn't the best thing for him. So I decided I'd take him. I actually got to drive down now and go throw him on the earth. And yeah, like when we hiked up the top of this hill, once we finally got that bloody camera put where I wanted it, I'm like, there's always deer up there. And like, they're so hard because they've got their, you're sort of coming up over and down in long grass and they got their heads down feed and whatever. And yeah, next minute you don't know that until they pop their head up. And then, but anyway, he was just in the scrub. It was a big bloody buck. He was a good buck. I'm not sure how much a GoPro picked up of him, but he had a boar with him. I saw the boar first and then the buck took off, like this low light sort of stuff in that, I can't see the screen, in that scrub up there where we were at the top there. Bloody, yeah, he wasn't moving, so you couldn't see a bloody thing until the pig went, and then the deer went with the pig. But no, that was awesome. We saw what we wanted to see and what we came for. And yeah, hopefully this camera shows us some awesome pictures of his buck. And yeah, what other bit of potential is here for the rut. Anyway, we're going to keep on hunting hard now. It's still it's summertime still, but I love hunting summer because that's the best time to kill a deer, like for eating quality. All the fat that they build up on the summer feed. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Thanks again for all your likes and subscribes. Really appreciate all the support. And yeah, until next time guys, we'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.